Assalamualaikum and hi students. So this is a video for BEKG 2443 Engineering Mathematics 2. So in this video, we will cover the first LO to know the concept of a function of more than one variable. Okay, we will start the second subtopic in this chapter, which is limits and continuity with limits. Okay, first we have definition 1.5, the definition of the limit. What is the limit? The limit of fxy, a two-variable function, when xy approaches point AB is equal to A. Okay, so written as limit xy approaches AB for fxy is equal to A. If and only if for any chosen positive number epsilon, however, there exists a positive number del such that, okay, you have modulus of fxy minus a is less than epsilon whenever 0 is less than square root of x minus a square plus y minus b square and less than del. Okay, so this is just the theory, the definition for limits. Now, we look at the theorem 1.1 for properties of limits of two variable function. Okay, we assume we have these two limits. Limit for fxy when xy approaches ab is equal to a, and limit for gxy, the second function g, when xy approaches to ab equal to b, capital B. Okay, so if the function of fxy is a constant equal to c, for example, you have fxy equal to 100, so the limit for this fxy when xy approaches to any value ab is equal to the constant, okay, 100. Okay, second properties, we have constant multiple rule. If you have limit of fxy multiplied by constant c equal to c multiplied by a, okay, you just multiply the c with a. Okay, then we have sum and difference rule. So you have plus minus of these two limit, you get a plus minus b. Okay, next you have product rule. For product rule, if you multiply, you have product rule of fxy with gxy, so the answer will be a multiplied by b. And then if you have quotient rule, fxy divided by gxy, so you have a divided by b. B must not equal to 0. So you cannot have a denominator equal to 0. Okay, and the last one, you have power rule. Okay, if you have a square root of n fxy. Okay, so the whole things will be power root of n. Okay, so you have n a to the power root of n, and if it is defined. About the existence of the limit, so the limit fxy when xy approaches ab can be defined as exists if and only if the limits along every direction as xy approaches ab are equivalent. Thus, to show that limit fxy does not exist in ab, the function needs to be shown having different limits along different directions when xy approaches a b. So to prove these two statements, we will look at example 2 after this. But first, let us look at the first example. Here we have to verify the following limits computations. Okay, so a, you have to find the limits for 2x squared plus 3y squared over 5xy plus 4y when xy approaches to 2, 3. X approaches to 2 and y approaches to 3. So to solve for this, for a, okay, so you have limit xy approaches 2, 3, and then 2x squared plus 3y squared over 5xy plus 4y. So this is equal to, what you need to do is just substitute your value of x and y. So 2 multiplied by 2 square plus 3 multiplied by 3 square divided by 5, 2 multiplied by 3 plus 4 multiplied by 2. And then the answer is 5 over 7. That's it. Okay, to find the limit. It's simple. And then for B, find the limit when x, y approaches to 0, 0. For x squared minus y squared over x plus y. Okay, for this one, if you just substitute the value of x and y, you have 0 squared minus 0 squared over 0 plus 0. And this will be equal to 0 over 0. But look at the denominator. The denominator here is equal to 0. So what does it mean? So this is undefined, since the denominator is equal to 0. So if you encounter this problem, this kind of limit, what you need to do instead of substituting the value of x and y is to factorize your function. So if you factorize this numerator, you have x minus y multiplied by x plus y, and it can be written as this. Okay, so from here you can cancel out this 2 term. So you just left with limit x y approaches 0 0 x minus y. Now you can substitute the value of x and y. So 0 minus 0 is equal to 0. Okay, so the limit for B is equal to 0. So from here you have this factorization. Okay, it is okay to get the limits equal to 0. Just you cannot have the 0 at the denominator. This is totally wrong. Okay, but if you cut the limit equal to 0, it is okay. In example 2, you need to show that the following limits do not exist. So refer to this one. To show that it does not exist means you need to show that the function has different limits along two different directions. Okay, so this is what we try to show. Example 2a. Okay, for limit x, y approaches to 0, x squared plus y squared over x squared minus y squared. Okay, to show that the limit do not exist, so you need to consider two directions, the limits from two directions. Okay, first, let us consider the limit from y direction. So when x equal to 0, y approaches 0. Okay, x equal to 0. So you must substitute the x equal to 0. So limit x, y, 0, 0. This limit x square plus y square over x square minus y square becomes limit x, y approaches to 0, 0. This is 0 square plus y square. So you left with y square over 0 minus y square. You have minus y square. So from here you have limit x, y approaches to 0, 0. And then you cancel these two. So you have minus 1. Okay. Cancel these two. You have minus 1. Okay. So for limit x, y approaches to 0, 0. You have minus 1. Minus 1 is constant. So this is equal to minus 1. Okay. Refer to the properties. When you have constant, f, x, y is constant, so the limit is constant, minus 1. So this is from the first direction. Next, move to the second direction when y equal to 0. So x approaches 0. Okay, for this one, limit x, y approaches 0, 0, x squared plus y squared over x squared minus y squared becomes limit x, y, 0, 0. Substitute y equal to 0. So you have x squared over x squared. So this is limit x, y approaches 0, 0. X squared divided by x squared is 1. So limit for function 1. So the answer is 1. Okay, so look at these two direction, limits from these two direction. One you have minus 1, another one you have 1. So what we can conclude here is that the limit does not exist since the limit from two different direction are not the same. Okay? So next, move to B. Limit xy when xy approaches to 0, 0. Sorry, limit xy when what? Limit xy over x squared minus y squared when xy approaches to 0, 0. So show that the limit does not exist. So for B here, the same things. We need to do the same things. So first consider x equal to 0 for y direction. Okay, for y direction. When x equal to 0. So limit xy approaches 0, 0 for function xy, x squared minus y squared will be limit xy approaches 0, 0. When x equal to 0 multiplied by 1, it becomes 0. Okay, and then when x equal to 0 minus y squared, you have minus y squared. Okay, any number, 0 divided by any number, 0 divided by 1, 0 divided by 3, it will be equal to 0. So limit xy, 0, 0 is 0. Okay, so this is equal to 0. So limit for 0, 0 is constant, is equal to 0. Okay, next, when y equal to 0 from x direction. Okay, so this limit xy approaches to 0, 0, xy over x squared minus y squared is equal to limit xy approaches 0, 0. Again, you have 0 multiplied by 1. X multiplied by 0. So you have 0 over x squared. Okay? So you have limit xy equal to 0, 0, 0 again. So this is 0. 0 divided by any number is 0. So the limit is equal to 0. Now, you see the limit from two direction, from y direction and x direction is equal to 0. But the question asks you to show that the limit do not exist. So what you need to do is to check with the third direction. Pick any value for y or x. For example, for this one, I would like to take y equal to 2x. I want to consider y equal to 2x. So this is as well from x direction. Okay? So the limit xy 0, 0, xy over x squared minus y squared from this direction when we substitute y equal to 2x becomes limit xy 0, 0, Substitute y with 2x give you 2x square. Again, this one you have 2x, x square minus 2x square. So you have minus 4x square here. So you have minus 3x square. You see? Okay, so this one you have 2x square, you have 3 minus 3x square, x square. So this is limit xy approaches 0, 0, minus 2 over 3. Okay, now this limit is equal to, since this is constant, so this limit is equal to minus 2 over 3. You see, the first direction is 0. The second direction is 0 as well. But when you try to look at the third direction, different direction, if it is still 0, so the limit does exist. But now, from the third direction, you have the different limit. So, the conclusion we can make is the limit doesn't exist. Okay? Okay, continue with the second part of this video. Okay, we have continuity. So the definition for continuity is given by definition 1.6 here. A function is defined to be continuous at point AB if the following three conditions hold. So it must hold these three conditions. It must satisfy these three conditions. Then you can conclude that the function is continuous. So the three conditions are, first, FAB is defined. So whenever you substitute the value for AB into the function FXY, it is must be defined. Second condition, the limit must exist. Okay. And the third one, the first and second value must be the same. Theorem 1.2 give the properties of continuous function. Okay, we assume that fxy and gxy, these two functions, are continuous. The following rules are also continuous. So if f and g are continuous, so these sum and difference, product, constant multiples, power and quotient rules are also continuous. Okay, so fxy plus gxy is continuous. You multiply f with g, it will be continuous. You multiply k with f or g, so it is continuous. And then you have power rule and quotient rule. All these are also continuous. So we have two examples here for continuity. The first one is to show that fxy equal to 3x plus y square is continuous at point 0, 0. So we have three conditions that need to be satisfied, that need to be held, so that then we can continue, we can conclude that this function is continuous at point 0, 0. So the first one is to make sure f 0, 0, when you substitute 0, 0 into fxy, is defined. So substitute x equal to 0 and y equal to 0. This is equal to 0. 0 value is defined. This is defined. So first, we have checked the first condition. The second condition we need to check is to make sure the limit for xy approaches 0, 0, AB is 0, 0, is exist. Okay. So 3x plus y square. So this one, to find the limit for this one, you substitute. Okay. X and y. So this again, we have 0. So the limit does exist. Okay. For this function. And the last one, you need to make sure that f 0, 0 is equal to limit x, y approaches to 0, 0 for 3x plus y square is equal. So, does it equal? So we have f00 equal to 0, and then we have limit equal to 0. So we can conclude that fxy is continuous at point 0, 0. Last but not least, we have second example to show that this function is not continuous at the origin. What does it mean by origin? Origin means point 0, 0. Okay, so your AB is equal to 0, 0. So for this one, consider the first condition. First condition is to find f 0, 0. So fxy, when xy equal to 0, is equal to 0. So f 0, 0 is equal to 0 here. Okay? Next, for the second condition, we need to prove that limit xy approaches to 0, 0 for this fxy exists. Okay, so how can we show that this limit exists? We just show that in our previous example here. We try to find limit for xy, x square minus y square. Okay, when xy approaches to 0. And the limit does not exist. Okay, just conclude here, the limit does not exist from previous example. So in this second condition, we fail to prove it. Okay, so this is not, I mean, for the first one it is defined, but for the second one it is not exist. The limit for fxy does not exist. So fxy here is not continuous. We can conclude this at origin, since the limit does not exist. Okay, this is how we want to show that the limit, the function is not continuous. Okay, so that's all for today's video. So we will continue with partial derivative and total differential in the next video. Thank you.